afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your episode 624, part 2, your Daily Bread passage, Success and Sacrifice, from Jennifer Benson Schult, S-C-H-U-L-D-T. And if I'm mispronouncing that name, I'm sorry. That's the only way I know how to say it. But today's passage is derived from 1 John 3:11-18. So if you're excited about this one, smash that like button. Comment something that has given you success from a sacrifice that you had to make. What is a success story from something that you had to sacrifice for? That you had to sacrifice something for? What is the result in success on that? But today is Tuesday, February 8th, 2022. So, subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share that video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that 100 subscriber mark by April the 18th, which is my birthday. So without further ado, success and sacrifice. Jennifer writes, during a summer study program, my son read a book about a boy who wanted to climb an alpine mountain in Switzerland. So practicing for this goal occupied most of his time. When he finally set off for the summit, things didn't go as planned. Partway up the slope, a teammate became sick and the boy decided to stay behind and help instead of achieving his goal. In the classroom, my son's teacher asked, was the main character a failure because he didn't climb the mountain? One student said yes, because it was in his DNA to fail. But another child disagreed. He reasoned that the boy was not a failure because he gave up something important to help someone else. He felt the need to give up on that dream to help somebody out. That's a win there sometimes. You have to sacrifice something to have success in something else. Or you have to sacrifice something to help out with something else, which will give you success. So when we set aside our plans and care for others instead, we're acting like Jesus. Jesus sacrificed having a home, reliable income, and social acceptance to travel and share God's truth. Ultimately, he gave up his life to free us from sin and show us God's love. 1 John 3:16. 1 John 3:16. So there is a 1 John 3:16, just like there is a John 3:16, which says, this is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down his life for us. I was getting ready to look at the Bible for it, but it's right there at the top of the page. So earthly success is much different from success in God's eyes. He values a compassion that moves us to rescue disadvantaged and hurting people. Verse 17. He approves of the decisions that protect people. And with God's help, we can align our values with his and devote ourselves to loving him and others, which is the most significant achievement there is. So, how has the quest for success affected your life? And why is it sometimes difficult to align our values with what matters to God? Some good ones. Ponder that by saying, Heavenly Father, I want to be successful in your eyes. Teach me how to love others the way you love me. So your Bible reading today is Leviticus chapters 4 and 5. And then we'll finish reading Matthew chapter 24 with 29 through 51. So that's 32 chapters. Or 32 verses. Excuse me, sorry about that. But that's all I have for today. A really quick one. I'm just a little over 5 minutes, I'm already done. It'll take a couple more minutes to do my closing. So tomorrow, in your part two of episode 625, for your glorious Hump Day Wednesday, February 9th, we're going to be talking about mortality and humility. We had success and sacrifice today. Tomorrow we'll talk about mortality and humility. From Wynn Collier, derived from James 4, 7-17. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that tomorrow after 1. Coming up tonight, after 7, with your turning point, your episode 150. We're going to be talking about Not Where I Wanted to Be, beginning with Acts 21:33 from the NIV, which will, and which I'll read the my version so we can understand the difference. So, Philippians 1, 12 through 19 is your recommended reading. Your turning point will be from Adoniram Judson. A-D-O-N-I-R-A-M. And Judson is J-U-D-S-O-N. And in your Bible reading, we're reading the next two chapters of Numbers 3 and 4. So, stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that after 7. But with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. A little shorter one than without all the rambling like I did this morning. So, but I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your terrific Tuesday afternoon. Come back again tonight for Not Where I Wanted to Be. Should be a dandy. So, but with that said, goodbye.